early one day after a restless night. I watched the stars burst and fill the morning sky with light. In my hazy days, I noticed something on my bedroom floor. It was an envelope I don't think I had seen before. I opened with caution and it did reside a map and a note that said, "Join me inside." I had nothing to do that day outside of my head, so I decided to just follow and see where it led. It led me to a door. I grabbed the handle and used it. Stood before me was the physical embodiment of music. I could barely believe my eyes. She was a sepia goddess. Every contour was perfection. Her demeanor was modest. Even armed with all this beauty, she was in no way belittling. I'd liken her body to the opening riff from Little Wing. Her eyes burned deep with the passion of an aimless chain gang. Her lips smiled with the vibe of son of a preacher man. She told me she'd evolved over time. We sat in this empty room with just a bed and some wine. We'd talk for hours about the things she's seen and done, but not boasting. We'd pour some Zinfandel, raise a glass and just toast things. We had a meeting of minds. She breathed new life in this old brain. She was the milk in my colour. I was the heart into her culture. Showed me scars she'd acquired each time a genius would depart. Jimi Hendrix on her left hand, Johnny Cash on her heart. Different fingers from Mingus Davis and a leg scarred for Elvis. Ray Charles and her eyelids. Jim Morris on her pelvis. Then she asked about me and my musical stylings. All the things in life I found somewhat inspiring. I paused, the wine making me feel quite cocky. Feeling whatever I said she would take in and not mock me. I said, "I'm a wordsmith and artist. I'm deep like the TARDIS. Every time I aim for something, I'm gonna hit the target." She joked, "Gangster rap?" I said, "No, but drop the G. You might start to get a better description of me." "Angster rap," she said. "If it sticks, you'll regret that." The most appalling moniker since the dawn of Dan LeSac. She was a sepia goddess, yet her demeanor was modest. Her hair was wild like the darkest, deepest of forests. Many before me had fallen at her feet and died. But that night, made a connection and she'd let me inside. She was a sepia goddess, yet her demeanor was modest. Hair was wild like the darkest, deepest of forests. Many before me had fallen at her feet and died. But that night, made a connection and she'd let me inside. Some of these clothes are looking old, just like my jaded character, who thinks like an old brother, but sometimes acts like an amateur. This hat's an old classic in the first stage of dilapidation. It's a fair valuation that is making this equation a little top heavy, if you know what I mean. Because there's a fine line between a classic and a has-been. As I finished that sentence, I noticed the sadness in her eyes. This moved me, left my mind wondering why. As we laid there, she buried her head in my chest. I wrapped my arms around her, stroked her with the sweetest caress. I wanted to find the right line that could make her sad head lift. Wanted a chance to breathe life back into music like Redshift. Said she'd grown sick and tired of the same shit. I said, "If there's anything in the world I could do, she should name it." She said, "Sit in public places and quietly observe all of this speech's mannerisms, every action and word. And something inspires me to concentrate on that thing. Get a pen and pad and then produce a vocal offering." She said, "Bring the lost art of conversation back. I'm sick to death of awkward silences and all that crap. It's time to talk to one another, share your thoughts and facts. Learn the monologue you give, the more you get right back." I looked her in the eyes and said I'd do what I could. Then she held my head and kissed me, but not like a lover would. But then it also wasn't like a close friend or relative. Instead of exciting, it was calming, like a spiritual sedative. And then we laid there until I woke in an empty room. If I couldn't still smell her skin, I'd be inclined to assume that I'd dreamt the whole thing, but I knew that I hadn't. And I'd seen the perfect balance of beauty and talent. After a moment of reflection, I rose to my feet. Opened the door with squinted eyes and stepped back into the street. I kind of staggered home and got out a pen, as she said, and wrote down my inspiration, and here's what it read. She was a sepia goddess, yet her demeanor was modest. Hair was wild like the darkest, deepest of forests. Many before me had fallen at her feet and died, but that night it made a connection and she'd let me inside. She was a sepia goddess, but her demeanor was modest. Hair was wild like the darkest, deepest of forests. Many before me had fallen at her feet and died, but that night it made a connection and she'd let me inside.
Thank you.
but her demeanor was modest. Hair was wild like the darkest, deepest of forest. Many before me had fallen at her feet and died, but that night we made a connection and she let me inside.